Well, someone's compensating. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is 6 looks, 1 palette with the big jawbreaker palette from Jeffree Star Cosmetics that I have right here. The look that I have is look number 5. And I really like how it turned out. This video will not be the review, that will be a separate video. This is just purely on 6 looks that I am doing with the Jawbreaker palette. And let me show you how I do the looks, basically. Here she is. I am going to go row by row. So this is look number 1, this is look number 2, then you have 3, 4, 5, 6. You get the drift, right? So today I played with this row here. Oh, and I still have some concealer on the back of my hand, because of the cut crease that I did. So yeah, I'm trying not to make them too complicated. So yes, I did a cut crease today, a half cut crease. I'm not doing full cut creases or anything like that. It is just the way that I would place the shadows on my eye. That's usually how I do all my looks, but yeah. Timestamps for the different looks will be down below. I will list the face makeup that I have on and the lipstick and the falsies and all that goodness, blush, bronzer, you know the drill, all down below for each of the looks. And I think that's it, guys. Yeah, let me know down below what your favorite look is, if you have the palette and all that goodness. I also have the Jawbreaker Mini. I'm going to do 3 looks with that one as well. I will try to have it up as soon as possible. But yeah, it's just very, very busy, so I'm doing my best. If you want to see that video and more of me, you know that you have to click that big red button down beneath this video. But yeah, guys, for now, let's just go to look number 1. The first look with the big Jawbreaker palette, and the first look is the first row, that one. So yeah, I have an idea. Let's see if I can achieve said idea. And excuse the noise, they are working on the sewer system still, or at least the day I'm filming, and my washing machine just decided to be done. So yeah, I have primed my eyes with the Catrice cream pot, camouflage pot in ivory, to get a lightest, the most light base I can get. That's very bad English, but you get me, I think. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with a packing brush, I think. I have here a flat but fluffy brush. I'm going to go into the color Virgin. I'm going to see if I can make it show up. Again, I have an idea. I don't know if I will succeed, but we will see. I'm going to press it on my eye. I can make it show up, so that's good. I'm not particularly wanting to blend this out. I just want to pack it on diagonally. And then just make sure I'm going over it, just to make sure it's not patchy and, well, it's going to be weird no matter what I do, but still. Did I say that my base was still tacky? I don't remember. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just kind of blend the edges a little bit and then just make sure that everything is as opaque as I want it to be. So, next shade I'm going to use is the color called Cute. I'm going to use the Morphe M506 and I'm going to place the color on my the outer part of my eye and maybe even blend it into the crease a bit. I'm also tapping this shade on. Just going to blend it into the white. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull it into the crease a tiny bit. I don't like the way that this line is looking. I'm going to take the brush I just used with the shade Virgin. I'm going to bring it on top here. Going back to the color Cute, that tealy shade. I'm just going to make sure it is all nice and blended and the way I like it, basically. In the color Cute, that tealy shade, just with the tips of the bristles, I'm just going to blend the edge and just make sure that it flows nicely. I'm cleaning my brush, I'm going back into the color Virgin, which was the white, and I'm going to pull that on top here a little bit and just again make sure that everything is nice and blended. I have here the Morphe E36 and the color called Lemon Drop. I'm going to spray and then put it in my inner corner. That's very, very cute. But I have one color left.
My brush went away, oh no.
I have here a very flat brush. I'm going to go into the color and what? I'm going to go on my lower lash line, on my, not in my waterline, but just below. I want it up a little bit as well to tie it together a bit more. I am stamping where I want the shade to go to create kind of a wing shape, you know? I am taking a softer flat brush in the same color, still the color and what? And I'm kind of going to fill in that wing shape that I made, or something along those lines. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start at that line and then I'm going to flick it in. And then I'm kind of just making a shadow wing thing idea. So with a clean brush, I'm going to flick it in and make it hopefully a little bit less harsh, because it's not really my vibe, this. I'm just going to pull it in without any extra product. I'm just going to blend it into the crease a little bit more. I'm going back into the color Cute. I'm just going to blend them here together a little bit as well. Cleaning the brush, I'm going to go into the color Virgin. I'm going to re-intensify the white. For eye pencil, the Essence Electric Vibes in Neon Love. For liner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. For mascara, the Benefit Bad Gal Bang. For falsies, the Sosu Glamlash Collection in Style London. For lipstick, the Catrice Generation Matte in Llama Poo. And that concludes the look. I like it. It is not exactly as I thought I would do it today, but I like it nonetheless. This was the first look. Let's get ready for the next one. Look number two, and I swatched the shades here because look number two is row number two, and we have another very light pastel here. So this is the second look. I'm going to prime my eyes a little bit differently today. Instead of a really light base, I'm just going to use the Catrice Eye Foundation. On my eyes now is foundation. So yeah. And the reason I'm doing this is because yes, I can get the base as light as possible, but I kind of don't want to today. I kind of want to see what the light shade does on top of, well, basically my skin tone, if I can make it show up. So I am going to start with a kind of a denser brush. It's still small, but it's a little bit more dense, and the color called Good Morning, that is going to go in the inner half of my eye. I'm going to press it on and let's see how opaque we can get it. I'm going to press it all the way back here, like I would do a full cut crease. I'm not going to, but I do want this to be the top shade, if that makes any sense. Now I'm going to blend the edge lightly. Oh yes, the whirring noise you hear, it's my tiny fan. It's hot here, in case you were wondering. Next brush is going to be the Morphe M506 and the color called, well, fuck. Yeah, it's what it's called, people. Ooh, now this is a very nice hot pink. I have a shirt that's kind of this color. Maybe I should have worn it today. I have here a flattish fluffy brush. A little bit of glitter glue on the brush, and then place it where I want it. Like so. Okay, then I'm going to go into the color Bite Me. That is going to go on the outside. I'm going to press it on diagonally. I know I'm going quite far in, but it is like a wing thing or something. I'm kind of going to treat this like eyeliner. I have here just a eyeliner brush, I think. I don't know. Let's, for funsies, create kind of a purpley wing. Let's make sure it's nice and filled in. And then into the color Orange Juice. And that one is going to go there where I have no shadow yet. Now I can kind of see where I put the glitter glue. So that is where I'm concentrating it. So I'm pretending to do a cut crease. I'm just not. That's fun. Okay, I'm going to kind of drag it on top of that purple a little bit here to get those two to mix. And normally purples and oranges don't mix, well, not prettily. But because these are shimmers, it's different. So they won't go muddy because they are shimmers. I'm going to grab my tiny Morphe E36 back in the color Good Morning. And I'm going to bring that pastel-y shape back till about halfway. Yes. Then I'm taking my Morphe M507 again into the color, I don't care too much. And I'm going to bring it a little bit more around. I am going to pull the orange a little bit more in my inner corner. So I have here the cream gel liner from ColourPop in Poppy. For eyeliner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. For mascara, the Benefit Bad Girl Bang. I am going to put on my falsies, which are going to be the Sosu in style Milan. For lipstick, Jeffree Star Velour Liquid Lipstick in Can't Relate. And then that concludes the look. I like it. I like how it turned out. It is not as I had planned. But then again, my looks usually turn out differently than what I plan anyway. I think it's cute. I feel nice and cute and summery, and I cannot wait to wear this for the rest of the very hot summer day that we have today. This was look number 2. Let me know down below what you think of it, and let's go to look number 3. Look number 3. I'm going to play with this row today. So yeah, face is ready to go, eyes are primed and not set, and I am going to start with the Morphe M506, the color called Cherry Wet, and that is going to go on my eye somewhere. I have a vague plan, and yeah, I'm going to start the outer part of my eye, just going to tap it on. It is a nice and vibrant color, which is good. Just going to pull in what I have there. Next color I'm going to take is going to be the color Gumdrop. I have here the Morphe 514, and I'm going to blend out that shade with this one. I'm concentrating it on the outer part of my eye. Just doing circles to get the two colors to mix a little bit. And kind of wing it out a little. I do feel, though, that I have kind of blended away that hot cherry wet shade, so I'm going to go back into the color Cherry Wet to bring it back a little. I'm taking a slightly different brush. This one is flat but fluffy. I'm going to go back into the color Cherry Wet. I'm going to place it underneath my eye. And now I'm going to go into the color Gumdrop. I'm going to blend it out with that. With a clean blending brush, I'm just going to go over everything here. I am going to go back into the color Cherry Wet, which is this one. And I'm going to build it up a little bit in the outer corner and the crease. And I'm just really just pretty heavily going to place it without blending it out at the moment. I'll blend it out, but placing it first. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to clean my brush and I'm going to kind of blend it up. So I want to blend it on the top part of the line that I just made. Like so. Okay, it is time to cut the crease. And I'm taking my concealer, a flat brush. I'm going to do a half cut crease. I've done it numerous times in various videos. So I'm going to do it off camera to save a little bit of time. So I'll be right back. So you see this eye, it was kind of a disaster slash... I made it work, so let me show you what I did. I think that's better. So I'm going to cut the crease, or a half cut crease. Going to do it really, really quickly, I hope. With a flat brush, but not very, very flat. A little bit of body. I'm going to go into the color Sour. And I'm going to put that on my eye. I'm just going to press it on the concealer. I'm also going to go over the outer corner here. But I'm pressing and I'm kind of flicking it in. Now I'm just going to make sure I don't have any weird patchiness. So let me get a brush and the color Bubblegum. It's going to go on the inner part of my eye where I have no shadow yet. Okay, now when I get to that green, I'm kind of flicking it on top. And these colors don't really want to mix nicely. They kind of get muddy. That's what happened here, but I kind of went with it. Does that make any sense? So here it is a little bit more muddy, but I will show you how I got it there, because I kind of like it actually. So I'm cleaning the brush that I'm using and I'm just going to go gently a little bit back and forth on that edge, because these colors just don't really want to mix. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the color Gumdrop and I'm kind of going to mix it in. So let's take a different brush, just a tiny bit of Gumdrop, and I'm going to stretch my eye and I'm going to concentrate that on the edge, on that border. So I'm going to go like that over the border and then a tiny bit flicking it one way and then another little bit of circles to just get that line not really sharp and harsh, you know? There, however, that is where I ran into trouble. So first I'm going to go into the color Cherry Wet, this one. Then I'm probably going to dip back into the green and then I'm going to use the purple. Yeah, so I'm going to build it up like that. So I'm going to start with the color Cherry Wet, which is that reddish color. I'm going to stamp it on and then kind of flick it into that green a little bit, doing a little bit of circles. Cleaning the brush, going in the color Sour, which is the green. Kind of doing the same thing. So I'm going to drag it on top of that color. Now I'm going to really pat on some of that green, just to make sure it is not patchy. Blend a little bit there. Okay, now I'm going to go into the color Gumdrop, which is that lavender. I'm going to place that here and I'm going to blend tiny circles. Place a little bit, clean the brush, get a little bit of the color Sour, which is the green, and work those two in. Then get a little bit of Cherry Wet, which is that reddish shade. And that's basically how I kind of created that muddy, weird look. And I'm just placing some of that green in the outer corner. I'm hoping it wants to stick. I don't think it does, though. I'm going to place the color Sour, that green, underneath my lash line as well. And because my eyes are pretty dry, I'm not going to use an eye pencil. I'm going to drag it on top of here as well, to kind of help with that muddiness that I have there. Then I have this brush. It has a little bit of the color Cherry Wet on it. And that is kind of how I got that muddy effect there as well. And I kind of like it, if I'm being honest. Let's just go over everything with a clean blending brush. I'm going to go into the color Bubblegum, which is the hot pink, just a tiny bit, and I'm going to pull it here on top to blend away that harsh line that I have here. Then I'm going to go into Cherry Wet, which is that darker reddish shade, kind of bringing it back here a little bit more. A little bit of the color Gumdrop, which is that lavender, and just tap it over and kind of blend it in a bit. For a liner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. For mascara, the Benefit Bad Gal Bang. For falsies, the Sosu InStyle London. For lips, the PS Nudes Lip Gloss in Player. And then that will conclude the look. So this was not really what I had in mind when I sat down this morning, but yeah, sometimes stuff happens, you know? Am I completely happy with the look? No, because there are things that I kind of should have done differently, you know? But this is what came out. I'm not hating the look. It's just not one of my favorites. And to be honest, not one of the best I have ever done. But it does not really matter, does it? Because it's makeup. I can wash it off. I do feel pretty in this. And this is a look where falsies make a difference. Just so you know, I am well aware. I don't mind it too much. I have those days sometimes as well. So yeah, guys, let me know what you think of this look down below, and let's get ready for the next one. Okay, okay, look number four is this roll. So yeah, face is ready to go, eyes are primed. What did I have in mind again? The yellow, yes. Let's start with the color Wow, which is the yellow. On a smaller brush, it's going to go in the inner part of my eye first. I'm just going to tap it on my eye because my base is still tacky. Let's see what happens. I want this quite low because I kind of want that pop of yellow in my inner corner as well. Just going to blend the edge a little, but I want that vibrancy of the yellow. So I'm just going to concentrate that blending on the edge. Okay, okay, yellow is kind of down. Let's go to the next color, which is the color Tasty, which is the brown. I'm going to use that in my outer corner, in the crease, and drag it forward probably. Every time I do a look with yellow, or if I do a yellow look, I want to kind of deepen it up with a brown. So I'm going to pull it a little bit into the yellow. I want it a little bit underneath my eye, but more in the outer corner here, just to make sure it is not weird, or at least not any more weird than it needs to be. Okay, a clean brush. I'm going to blend the edge a little bit of that brown. Yes, then I'm going to go back to the color Wow, which is the yellow. And I'm going to blend it a little bit more with that. And I'm just going to blend the two together a little bit. Dipping back into the brown, called Tasty. Then a little bit back into the yellow, called Wow. To kind of layer them on top of each other a little bit. I have here the eyeshadow primer from Wet n Wild. And this is very, very sticky and tacky. And usually it's a bit too drying for my eyelid sometimes. But let's see what it does when I use it as a glitter glue. Then go into the shade called Snack, which is also gorgeous as a face highlight, by the way, at least for me. Very, very pretty. I'm going to go back to the color Tasty, which is the brown, to blend the edge here. And let's go into the color Soaked, which is the blue. It's going underneath my eye and a little bit in the outer corner as well. I'm just going to kind of fade it up a little bit to get it to mesh a little bit better. I'm kind of liking this. I am, however, going to cheat. Because I want a little bit of inner corner highlight, I don't feel like grabbing another palette, so I'm grabbing the color Jawbreaker, which is a little bit yellowy. I'm just going to press it on a tiny bit in the inner corner to get that yellow to be just a little bit shimmery. For eye pencil, the Essence Electric Vibes in hashtag sorry not sorry. For eyeliner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. Mascara, top lashes, Catrice Glam & Doll in waterproof. Mascara, bottom lashes, Etos Volume Mascara in blue. For falsies, the Soso Glam Lash Collection in Style London. For lipstick, the BH Cosmetics Liquid Linen in the color, I think, Guliana. And here is the finished look. I think it's pretty. Oh yeah, and if it looks like my lips are overdrawn, they probably are, but it's by accident, just so that you know. But I think the look turned out nicely. This was look number four. Yeah, let's get ready for look number five. Look number five. And it's going to be, well, probably an all matte look today, because at least the shades that I have are all matte. So this is the row I'm working with. And I have an idea. I'm not going to tell, because usually then my ideas go straight out the window. It's going to involve a cut crease, half cut crease, just so that you know, just because of the colors that I'm working with today. So let me start with the e.l.f. crease brush and the color Raspberry. And that is going to go in my crease. I primed my eyes, I haven't set it, and I'm just tapping the color on. Now, because I'm going to cut the crease, I'm placing this shadow higher than I normally would, because I kind of know where I need to cut the crease, and I want a little bit more depth. And I also want this underneath my eye, close to the lash line. I have here a soft, fluffy brush. I'm going to blend out that red a tiny bit. before I place the orange. Yes, I have here a, it's a blending brush. It's a little bit bigger. It's very soft. It's a little bit denser than the last one. I'm going to blend out the edge first. Yes, and that goes really nicely. So that is good. With the same brush, I'm going to go into the color called Suck, which is the orange. And I'm going to blend out this shade that I have on my eye, the color Raspberry, with this one. I'm also going to place it because I want to be able to see the orange. Okay, I'm also going to place it on top of that red. Yes, I think I need to bring a little bit of that color Raspberry back in the outer corner. So I'm going to do that with a smaller brush. Just so that I have something for that for the other shades to blend into in a minute. I'm getting my concealer and a flat brush and I'm going to do a half cut crease. So I have here a flat brush, but still a little bit fluffy. I'm going to go into the color Brain Freeze. That's going to go on my eye, but on the outer part of the cut crease. It's going to go diagonally. I'm actually going to place it a little bit more on my lid, because of course I have another idea. Yes. Okay. With whatever I have left here, I'm just going to kind of mesh those two colors together. Just a tiny bit. Then I will take my blending brush. This is the Morphe M507 in the color Raspberry to blend them together. And now I'm kind of creating a different shade, but I like that. A little bit more purpley. I'm going to kind of try and make the transition as nice as possible. Dipping into Brain Freeze again, the blue, and just make sure it's not patchy and such. I like it. Okay, I have another color left. I have a tiny flat brush. I'm going to go into the color Cone, which is the last color that I need to use today, and that is going to go there where I have no shadow yet. And then I'm just going to fade it into the blue, or at least that's the idea. So let's blend them together a little bit on the edge, or at least try to. I'm dipping into the color Cone a tiny bit, and then in the color Brain Freeze. I like that. Cool. Okay, I want that color Brain Freeze underneath my eye as well. So I have here a tiny brush, the Morphe E36. Okay, then a little bit of the color Raspberry for the outer corner here, so that I can kind of mesh them together like I did up top. For eye pencil, the Essence Electric Vibes in hashtag Paradise. For eyeliner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. For mascara, the Benefit Bad Gal Bang. For falsies, the Primark Glam Lash in Style London. For lips, the NYX Turned Up in Mirage. And then here is the finished look. I like it. And it was, well, almost as I had planned. So yeah, this was look number 5. We have one left. Let me know down below what you think of this look. Maybe you would have done something different with the colors that I had to work with today. Let me know down below. And for now, let's get ready for the last look. The last look. And it's kind of sad that it is coming to an end. But I am not done playing by a long shot, just so you know. Oh no, yeah, I forgot. I did not forget to put in earrings today. So I don't know what's happening. But yeah. The last look is the last row, this one. And yeah, I'm going to start with the red. I don't want the red too vibrant. Then I'm going to deepen it up with the blue, put the shimmers on my lid, and then that's basically it. So it's not going to be too complicated today. But I know that I say that sometimes, and then yes. Let's start with a big fluffy brush and the color called Licorice, which is the red. Which is weird, because licorice here is not red. I don't even know what the red licorice tastes like, because we just have the black licorice. The way it is kind of supposed to be, you know? But does not matter. Let's put this down as kind of a transition shade. And this is such a good brush for that. I'm just going to slowly build it up, pull it up a little bit higher. And then with the tip of this brush, because it has a tip, I'm going to pull it underneath my eye a little bit as well. Okay, so now instead of pink,
It's more.
No, instead of red, it's more pink. But I like that. That was what I was going for. So that's good.
Okay.
That is done. Next, I am going to take my e.l.f. crease brush in the color Delicious. And I'm going to deepen up the outer corner and the crease. I need a different brush. I need something a little bit softer. Because I can kind of still feel it dragging a little bit. Well, someone's compensating. I'm just going to really blend those two colors together. Okay, so now I have a little bit of that depth. I'm going back into the color Licorice, which is the red. I'm going to place that on top. I have done so many red, white and blue looks lately that I don't want this to be a red, white and blue look. Okay, dipping back into Delicious a little bit, that blue. Yeah, this is more of what I want. And you have that depth without it being, well, apparently red, white and blue. You know? I am getting a flat brush. This is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Eyeshadow Primer. I'm going to put that a tiny bit on my brush. Yes. That's going to go on my lid, kind of like a cut crease. And then I'm going to fill it in with shimmers. That's basically what I'm going to do. And the shimmers from Jeffree Star's palette are opaque enough that you can use them this way. This is just a lot quicker. So I'm going to go into, I think Jawbreaker first, which is this one. And that's going to go in the inner part of my eye. Now I'm taking the brush that I used before, the bigger one, and I'm going to go into Cotton Candy. And I have been dying to play with this shade, so let's flop it on the brush. And put it on the eyeball. Oh, yes. Oh, I love this shade. I'm kind of going to merge Jawbreaker and Cotton Candy thingy together. Switching brushes. A little bit of Jawbreaker. Cute. Let's get a blending brush with a little bit of Jawbreaker on it. And Jawbreaker is also gorgeous as a face highlight, just so you know. Yeah, I like that. I'm taking a little bit of the color Delicious, that dark blue, to, well, kind of merge here a little bit more. And then kind of pull it forward. I have a little bit of Cotton Candy left on my brush. I'm going to pat that on top. I like that. I want it underneath my eye as well, but I'm taking a different brush, and this time I am going to spray it. I like that. Yes, I like that a lot. I also want a little bit of a Jawbreaker underneath. Yes, I want to smudge underneath my eye. I don't know what I have on this brush, but it does not really matter. And then that is almost the eye look done. Let me get my other eye up to speed first. I think that's a better idea. Okay, both eyes are kind of up to speed. Let's get... Is it an eye pencil? Wow, it's an eye pencil. That's fun. Usually I just plop a lip pencil in. But I have here an eye pencil from Essence. Long lasting in the color. Life in Pink. For eyeliner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. For mascara, the Bad Gal Bang. For falsies, the Sosu Glam Lash Collection in Style Milan. For lipstick, the L'Oreal Rouge Signature in Eye Empower. And then that concludes the look. I like it. I feel nice and summery. At first I was looking at kind of pink lips, but because I have that that lighter part there, I kind of wanted to draw a little bit more attention to that and not be too pink. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but I just did not feel like it today. And I think it's not exact, of course it's not exact, but it is fun. So what I can do, however, is get a little bit of Jawbreaker on my finger. Yeah, that does not really help, does it? Anyway, it does not really matter. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, or such. So guys, this was it for my 6 looks with the big Jawbreaker palette by Jeffree Star Cosmetics. I hope I gave you some alternatives to, well, the kind of standard looks that I saw done with this palette. And Yeah, maybe it gave you some new inspiration and color combinations that you would not have chosen yourself. And that, to be quite frank, I would not have chosen myself. So yeah, it kind of took me out of my comfort zone as well. And that is why I really like doing my looks videos like this. That's basically it. Yeah, I'm not done playing with this palette. I do have to say though that I have a lot of other palettes to go through. So I don't know when I will get to play with this one again. But it is coming because it's such a fun palette. You know, I had a lot of fun creating the looks for you guys. And more will be coming. Just keep an eye on my channel. And if you have not hit the subscribe button yet, well, you know where it is. I think it's the big red thing down there. Click it and then... Well, we can become friends. I would like that very, very much. And I hope you will like that too. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. But be nice about it. And for now, I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I hope to see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys.